Hi, my name's Leah, and welcome to Leah Loves Science, where I answer niche, but necessary, science questions. Today's video is going to be a bit different from my usual sort of content. Last week, I found out that my friend Mick Pete had sadly passed away. Mick was a Derbyshire legend who was passionate about promoting folk music in Derbyshire, particularly passionate about promoting it to young people. And he had a massive influence on my life, and I know he had a massive influence on many other young people in the Derbyshire folk scene. And I've been pretty devastated about it and trying to find a good way to remember him, basically. And I've settled on this video. So the UK has a rich and varied folk tradition, which includes folk music, folk dancing, like Ceilidh dancing and Morris dancing, and folk songs. And within folk music, there are several instruments that kind of pop up all the time. So things like fiddles, string instruments, whistles, and squeeze boxes. Now, a squeeze box is any instrument that makes a sound by using a pair of bellows to push air over a set of reeds. And that sounds kind of complicated, but you gotta bear with me. You've definitely seen squeeze boxes before. Pirates always play concertinas, those little tiny round squeaky things. Weird Al Yankovic actually plays the accordion, and I play, oh, it's quite heavy, the melodeon. Now, Mick lent me my first melodeon, which I'm sure Mum and Dad were really pleased about. So I thought it would be the perfect thing to talk about during this video. We'll talk about the science of squeeze boxes, and I will take one apart for your enjoyment, because I'm also an engineer and it kind of comes with a job. So melodeons, unlike accordions, have buttons on both sides. Accordions have got a keyboard here instead of buttons, and a lot more buttons on this end, so kind of more complicated here, more simple on this side. And this is a DG 2.5 row melodeon, which means it has a row in the scale of D, a row in the scale of G, and a little ditty half row just there, full of random notes that let you play in other keys. That was so much more horrible than I was expecting. So one of the key differences between a melodeon and an accordion is that a melodeon plays different notes depending on whether you're pushing and pulling. So where accordion plays only one note, melodeon has two. Which is super exciting and means there's a lot of managing the bellow space while you're playing, because if there's a lot of push notes all in one space, you tend to run out of room. Which is why there's also an air button on the side here that lets you open and close the bellows without making a sound. Well, it does make a sound, but it's less loud. And on this side we have pairs of buttons. So there's a bass and there's a chord. And that lets you play nice accompaniments under the music that you're playing on this side. And it also lets you do this, which is an excellent feature that all instruments should have. So that's the outside of box, which is the name I have given my melodeon. On the inside, there are tons of like blocks of basically a harmonica. So some in this side, some in that side. And that's because the melodeon is basically a reed instrument, like a saxophone or a clarinet, but where they have reeds made out of cane, the melodeon has three reeds, which is a reed that is attached at one end, like a tongue. Not my tongue, because I have a tongue tie, but like most people's tongues. And that reed sits within a very tightly sort of fitting frame where it can wiggle like this, but not side to side. And when I push a button, it opens a little like palate, they're called, and it lets air through a hole over a reed and in or out of the bellows. And that reed vibrates in its little frame and that makes a noise. And that's how the melodeon makes sounds. Lovely. A melodeon, as I said, makes a noise, a different sound if you go in or out on the bellows. So that means there's actually two notes for each button. And these notes have, they're called valves that block the airflow of one way or the other, depending on if it's a push or a pull note. But it's actually a little leather strip. Valve is a very fancy word for such things. So it's very important in a melodeon like this that the leather strip fits very perfectly and very flush against the hole. Another thing that's important about melodeons is the sound. So something that differentiates them from an accordion is the number of reeds that play at any one time. So accordions tend to sound more like this. You see, it's quite a, it sounds French. It sounds like an accordion. You've heard an accordion before. But melodeons, a traditional melodeon sound, tends to sound more like this. And you might be able to hear there's like a slight wobble in that note. It's a bigger note because there are two reeds playing the same note at the same time. And part of the sound of a melodeon is that those two reeds are very slightly out of tune with each other, which puts that wobble in the air as they like fight in the air, in your ear. But it also gives it a very characteristic sound. This melodeon is a very fancy melodeon. You can see it's got an extra stop just here. And that puts an extra block of reeds. They're still playing the same note, but a lower version. Which is a really, really nice, like really thick, round sound, which is kind of perfect. You see the stops on this side as well. That takes the lowest note out of the bass. And this edits the chord. So where this is a G major, I can turn it into more of a generic G note. And that's how I tend to have it set, because committing to major this, minor this for every single chord is kind of a lot. It doesn't leave you a lot of wiggle room. And it also sucks for playing with other people, because then they're stuck with G major or E minor or whatever it is you're playing. Now you might be saying at this point, Leah, I've never seen a melodeon before. For all I know, everything you say is lies, squeeze box lies. And you know what? You should be asking for evidence, because this is a science channel. We're all scientists here, probably. So may I say, introduce Squishy. Squishy is a toy melodeon that I've also named. And Squishy works exactly the same as the big melodeon, but was significantly cheaper. So if I fail to put it back together again, it's not gonna be a massive problem. So Squishy wasn't built quite as well as Box. I'm now becoming embarrassed by these names. Squishy wasn't built quite as well as Box. As I say, melodeons make a sound when you push a button down, or they move if you push the air button. Otherwise, a melodeon shouldn't open or close. It means they've got an air leak, and it kind of ruins the sound when there's an air leak, because it's not as loud or as nice. Squishy has quite a big air leak. That's a lot of opening.
No, that's a lot of damage!
Which means there's a leak somewhere. It could be in the bellows, or it could be around these seams here. I guess that's something we'll find out. Squishy also takes a long time to play a note, so it takes a long time for the reed to sound or to speak. Which could mean that the reeds don't fit very well. It also sometimes plays notes when it shouldn't, which means the valves don't fit very well. So I guess that's something we'll find out when we crack them open. So this is Squishy up close. You can see it's got beautiful butterfly detailing just here, and whatever this is on the side, on the bellows. So this is where the sound comes out here. This is the grate. And this is the grate on the other side with its little feet. So I'm gonna take the front panel off first. Nice. So this is the beautiful grate itself. And inside we can actually see the pallets. So as I push buttons, each of the pallets comes up and reveals the hole underneath to let air through, which is super cool. A lot of melodeons actually have this on the outside, so you don't have to take a panel off. All this is visible and it looks super cool while you're playing. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take off this whole side so that you can see the reeds inside and the side of the bellows. It's going to be a struggle. Pliers have destroyed the pin. Free him. Yes! Stunning, flawless. So inside here we can see the bellows, and at the bottom there, those are the reeds that belong to this side. But really, we're interested in these. So this is the harmonica that I was talking about. You can see each of these gold pieces is the reed sat in its little frame. And each of these little flaps here are the valve of the reed on the opposite side. So each of these has got a little valve on the inside to stop air going that way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this out and hopefully play it like a harmonica. So this here is the harmonica or the reed block that I rescued from Squishy. I'm gonna attempt to play it like a harmonica because I feel like that's the thing that should be possible. So even the tiny melodeon has that classic melodeon sound because it has two reeds that are playing the same note, one either side. That one's a dud. Now you too are a melodeon expert. I urge you to go forth and share this information with the world. And while you're at it, check out what local folk traditions are in your area. The UK's got some really cool stuff. A lot of it's pretty weird and been revived fairly recently, which is awesome. There is very violent football in Derbyshire, the Shrovetide football. There is a weird horse thing in North Cornwall called Obios, which I believe is a May Day tradition. There is Beltane in Scotland, where they have a huge fire festival. And there is some sort of weird thing in Cambridgeshire that they're insisting is a bear. I'll let you decide for yourself. It is called the Straw Bear. Mick was really passionate about sharing folk with people. If you ever got a free ticket for a gig or a ceilidh from me, that ticket always came from Mick, and I strongly suspect he was paying for it out of his own pocket. He donated instruments to children with reckless abandon, no matter how loud the instrument was. And he organised event after event for the Derbyshire folk scene so that it was always popping. So this is me sharing my love of folk with you. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was a little bit different from my usual content, but if you enjoyed it, please give us a like below and subscribe to the channel via the orb. If you've got ideas for future videos or more questions for me to answer, leave them in the comments below or check out Leah Loves Science on Facebook and Instagram, and you can message me on there. And if you want to see more of this channel's videos, we have the Who Likes Science Short Shorts playlist right here. Bye. Mic's in the wrong place for this. No. No. Ooh, we've forgotten a lot of tunes.